In today's video, we're going to talk about how to kick those naysayers in your life to the curb and get rid of that negative for good. Coming up next. Hi, everybody. My name is Dee Burks, and this is Retirement Rescue, where we talk about how to make money, save money, and live well in retirement. Well, in today's video, we're going to be talking about how to get rid of those naysayers in your life. Not long ago, I uploaded a video about how to set your monster goals, those big goals. And in that video, I talked about setting my retirement goal of $2.5 million and trying to achieve that goal over the next 5 years. Well, like everybody, I have naysayers in my life just like you do. Now, these naysayers, they may be friends or family, or they just may be acquaintances, people you meet on the street. I mean, it's one thing for people to troll your YouTube channel and tell you you're full of it. It's quite another for someone to show up in your front yard. Happened to me today. There's an old guy strolling by my house today, and he says, "So I hear you think you're going to reach $2.5 million in 5 years. What makes you think you can do that, girly?" Yes, he called me girly. Now, I have to admit, my first reaction was to laugh. Because honestly, his opinion doesn't matter. It really doesn't. But it really kind of got me thinking after that little encounter. There are a lot of people that struggle with putting their goals out there or telling people their goals because they're afraid of the judgment they're going to get. They're afraid of all those people who are going to tell them how they can't do it, how they're not smart enough, how it's stupid, how, you know, they're never going to get ahead. What are they thinking? And that's a real fear. It's a real fear of a lot of people. Now, normally these days when someone does that to me, I realize right up front, that's a reflection of how they feel about themselves. It has nothing to do with me. But it took a lot of years for me to get to that point. It is hard, especially when you're younger and you haven't been through a lot, not to believe what people tell you. When they tell you, you're not smart enough, you can't do this, girly. It would be easy to believe that, but it's just not true. I realize the value of putting your goals out there, the value of setting those Godzilla goals, those monster goals, and how far it moves you ahead is really a product of my own experience. I have experienced setting big goals. I have experienced reaching them. I have experienced having to try to get those naysayers out of my head. And it's not necessarily easy. But let's talk a little bit about how that works. Now, when someone makes a negative comment toward you or toward your goals or talks about how you can't do something, realize it truly is a reflection of them. It is a reflection of their own fears. It's a reflection of their own inability to learn new things or their own desire to learn new things. And the funny thing is, a lot of times this negativity can come from friends and family. And they honestly believe they're doing you a favor and helping you by not allowing you to set goals that are too hard or too high or, you know, that might cause you to fail. They think they're helping you. They're not helping you. It's especially common right now because here we are on the tail end of the pandemic and people's fears are at an all-time high about everything, about the economy, about jobs, about your ability to earn money, about what you are or aren't going to be able to do, about your health, about the future. There are so many fears. It is just rampant. Not only is it difficult to get your own mental health straight when that stuff is going on, it's really difficult if you have to be around people that are all gloom and doom. Now, I'm not saying gloom and doom isn't occasionally warranted. It certainly is. But it can't be a constant thing. You know, it is depressing and it stops you in your tracks. One of the benefits of having gone through really bad stuff, although it doesn't really seem like it at the time, is that it teaches you, no matter how bad things are, it's temporary. You know, when people talk about, everything is temporary, you know, things always change, it's usually in reference to the good. They're saying, oh, the good never lasts, blah, 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 because they're negative people. But truthfully, the bad never lasts. The sun comes up tomorrow. If you start something new and you fall completely on your face, so what? The sun comes up tomorrow. It's not a big deal. And I think there is a certain benefit to having lived through really bad things and being forced to overcome them that gives you that confidence. Not only the confidence that things always improve at some point, but also the confidence in yourself that you can do things. You can overcome things. Someone else's opinion of you absolutely does not matter. They don't determine your future. You do. Now, when really uncertain times happen, as we've just seen, it affects people largely in two ways. Either they become extremely fearful, and boy, have we seen a lot of that, to the point it's like they're scared of their own shadow. They are scared of everything and everybody, and everything is just negative and gloomy, and oh my goodness, the sky is falling, oh my goodness. Either it affects them that way, or it increases your risk tolerance. That's what happens to a lot of people. Instead of seeing things as gloom and doom, they try to put it in perspective and say, okay, this is a risk I'm just going to have to deal with, and I'm going to go on with my life. And for anyone who's been through something like a divorce, a death, they've lost a job, they've lost a business, been through bankruptcy, you realize it increases your risk tolerance for those things. You're not afraid anymore that they're going to happen because you know it did happen. I got through it. I'm okay. So you're not afraid to try those things again. You're not afraid to do another business. You're not afraid to get into another relationship. You lose that fear because you have been able to handle it. It raises your confidence in yourself and gives you the ability to continue to move forward. And that is a valuable thing, because the next time something uncertain and scary happens, and there's always a next time, you won't be afraid to look for solutions. You don't sit there and wallow and get depressed because things seem so gloomy to the point you're completely helpless. You figure out, what do I need to do? What do I need to learn? Where do I need to go? How do things need to change? And you start doing those things in that time of uncertainty, and you bring yourself through it mentally. Now let's talk about how to deal with all that negativity and those naysayers. Number one, no one can give you permission to be happy but you. I realize that sounds very easy to say because we're all affected by the people we're around all the time. And if you have people that you're around who are consistently and repeatedly negative, whether that be family, friends, coworkers, the best thing you can do for your own mental health is to step away from that. It's human nature to want to engage those people and say, oh wait, you're wrong, it's not that bad. No, that's not productive. Because people who are drowning in negativity want to hang on to that negativity. They want everyone else to be negative with them and commiserate with them. You're not going to fix that. It's not your job, and it shouldn't be. Your job is you, taking care of you. Sometimes that means stepping back. It's okay not to engage. It's okay to pretend like you didn't even hear the comment. You didn't even hear the discussion. Just go on about your business. That's okay. When someone approaches you, like old fart, in your front yard, listen to their opinion and then go right on with yours as if they never said a thing. And that's what I choose to do. You have the right to create your own life and create your own happiness, whether anyone else agrees with it or not. But don't let those naysayers kill those monster goals. They are not in charge of your life. Do you want to look back a year or 2 years from now and feel horrible that you allowed someone's opinion of what you could or couldn't do affect your ability to get it done? Those people aren't living your life. You are. Those people aren't making your choices. You are. Those people aren't going to create your retirement. You are. And if you want to get it done, you've got to kick those naysayers to the curb and focus on you. Now, if you like these videos, be sure and click the subscribe button and share with someone you think could benefit. Thanks so much for watching. See you next video.